from Jim Firestone Field inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. It is NBC football here on the Toledo Sports Network. Northern Buckeye Conference action here between the Genoa Comets and the Lake Flyers. The battle of 795. Hi, folks. Mick Gonzalez here. We've got the band back together again as I welcome in my partner, Mr. Steve Taylor. And, well, Steven, welcome, my friend. Good to have you back.
Oh, man, it's always a good to be back here. It's like home, man. It's like I never left this place, man. You know, good old Friday night football here at Jim Firestone Field.
Yep, inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. We'll get into that as the game goes on. More importantly, also important is that we've got a football game to be played here. And now you've got the Lake Flyers who, well, they've had their struggles this season, but they are looking to try and turn that tide. And what a better way to do it than against your rival from just down the road.
Boy, you know the good old Lake Genoa rivalry never gets old, and we're going to see the next edition of it here tonight. Lake is going to come in, and they're going to be trying to fly high, man. But the thing about them tonight, Mick, for them, ball control is going to be key for these guys. They're going to have to control the ball against Genoa if they want to be successful, and they have a quarterback in Caleb Tobias that has the ability to be able to control the game and the clock.
Yep, he'll be splitting time out there along with Joe Clay, so it'll be interesting to see who actually carries most of the load. So, but of course, on the Genoa side of things, it's Aiden Brunkhorst. And Mr. Brunkhorst, that guy has got a cannon for an arm, good old number seven. And he is a guy that he's a big fella, and he plays like it.
Well, people, the wing tee days of Genoa football is gone. They've spread the football out. They utilize the spread, and Mr. Brunkhorst has the ability to do just that. I had a chance to go back and look at some of their footage against Fostoria last week. They utilize a lot of 2x3 sets. What I mean is they emptied the backfield, and they utilize their scheme to try to create mismatches to their advantage. They're going to do that again tonight. Is Lake up to the task? We'll find out here soon.
Okay, well, Genoa won the toss but have deferred to the second half, so Lake will get the ball first. Looking forward to what should be it's been a wonderful night here, senior night for the Genoa Comets. And, of course, you also have the dedication of Jim Firestone Field to honor the legendary Genoa Comet coach. Coached, I believe, from 59 until 76. So we look forward to what should be an entertaining football game. We're glad you could join us here on a cool, breezy night. It isn't real windy, but it is a breezy night here in the fall. Agler kicks off. It'll be a short kick. It'll be picked up there by Brandon Darr. So he goes outside, and he'll be brought down. Looks like it'll be
51. Zach Beerbaum was on the tackle and knocked him down, and it's a good start. So here we go. We get a good chance to see exactly what Lake is going to do. My gut feeling is they're gonna try to a little bit of power football, which might not be a bad idea.
Well, we'll see what happens. First and 10 here for the Flyers. They have it at their own 36-yard line. In the shotgun. They go forward, and it is Joe Clay, the quarterback, and he is dropped. And, well, looks like he lost about 2 yards. So Andrew Zapile in there on the stop for Genoa. And I tell you what, it's going to be a long night for the Flyers if they're not able to pave a little parking space in there for Mr. Clay here as we go second down again. Here's the snap. The ball is handed off there over to Savario Prophet. Prophet moves the football. Not only, he's going to be about 2 yards short of a first down.
Boy, Lake did a good job at setting the edge, getting to the outside, and allowing him to get to the edge to get positive yardage. But Genoa has snuck that extra safety down in the box, so it's a single safety high, so they're really loading that box to try to control the run.
So it'll be third down and 2, the ball at the 44. Great night for football. Oh, and the flags fly. We got movement there up front here for the Flyers. So they're going to take it back 5 yards, and that's the last thing you want.
Yeah, especially, you know, when you know it's a running play, you really want to get that extra start. You saw it right there, anticipating the snap, and it's going to bring up a third and long now.
Third and 7 here for the Flyers as they'll move the ball back to their 39-yard line.
Down and distance changes everything, and let's see what they come up with. Joseph Clay comes in.
Yep, Clay, who's a 5'11", 185-pound senior. He's got twins out to the left. Here's the snap. Clay rolls out there with him. He's going to toss. Oh, in and out of the hands. Unfortunate play there.
Nate Wagner dropped it on the outside. Wagner had run a stick route. You see him right here. He goes to the sticks, and he just stops and turns around. But what he does, he takes his after ball. You see him right there. Take his after ball. Ball goes down.
Yep. How many times have we seen that? You look before you catch the ball. You look out ahead of you to see what's there. Palmer back to punt here for the Flyers. Messenger back to receive this fourth down punt. That was nearly blocked. And it goes. He angled it, and ooh, that one did not go far.
No, that's going to count as an explosive for the Genoa special teams right here. They force a shank punt.
Well, Palmer, I mean, he was trying to avoid that one getting blocked. So they're going to spot the ball, wow, at the Genoa 47. So instant field position here for the Comets.
So we're looking at like a 12-yard punt.
Well, here we go. First and 10 for the Comets. Empty backfield, trips out to the right. We've got a whistle. Looks like it's an official timeout. Got a receiver over here with the back plate showing, and
they
don't like that.
You know, when you look good, you feel good. When you feel good, you play good, you know, and I guess that's all a part of this whole deal here.
Well, you better tell Mason Drummond that. Anyway, substituting in there for him is Denver Stewart. They go to the left this time. The pass is complete to Austin Teat. That'll be a pickup of about 7.
Boy, that's second. Nice read right there. Just quick check with me type route.
Yeah, that's what you want, and that's basically what is their bread and butter, is the short passes. They'll go long, but the short passes are usually are what turn into long gains. It's always the yak, yards after catch.
Absolutely, absolutely. Again, here you go, another 2x3 set.
Mm-hmm. Second down. Bronkhorst drives up the middle. He'll pick up a first down. And, well, his forward progress takes him to the 41. And
great.
Genoa fans not happy there because they took a long time to blow that whistle.
Yeah, a little extra curricular activities, but good push up front for the Genoa offensive line.
Yeah, the Buffet boys did a nice job in that effort. It's first and 10 here from the Lake 41. Empty backfield here as Bronkhorst going to go deep. Fires a dart on the right side. And, well, overshoots his target.
Well, I tell you, Brandon Dar did a good job at just doing his job, Mick. All he does is he bodies up his man. He knows that's what the route is. He knows that that's an out route going to the outside. All he has to do is play his position. Dar did it well.
5'8", 155-pound junior is Brandon Dar. Wasn't that 9:14 to go here. Want to make sure we tip our hat here to one of our sponsors here for Toledo Sports Network's coverage of high school football. That, of course, being Maumee Bay and Turf. Big shout out to Brad Morrison. Here's the handoff. Go. Aiden Antry goes for a first down pickup. Boys, he was brought down finally by Joe Clay, but not before a first down.
Great blocking at the point of attack. You see the offensive line get to the next level, into the next level to try to create running lanes. They do that just there, giving them a whole different look, and here we go with the single wing tee.
Yep. They like to mix it up, so here
they
we go.
They do a good job of it because they've always done this.
First and 10 here from the Lake 28. Here's the handoff to Antry once again. Antry driving forward, and he was able to pick up a couple of extra yards because of driving the keeping the legs moving, and that's what you want to do. And he gets it inside the 25 to the 23, the second and five.
Genoa coaching staff doing a good job at keeping the Lake defense off balance. They really came out. They spread them out. Now they're starting to load up in the box, and they're going after them.
Second and five from the Lake 23 in the wing tee. Antry again. He flies through, beats his one last man, and takes it in for a touchdown. 23-yard scamper, touchdown, Genoa.
You know, Antry does a great job at scoring the football, but what this is all set up by the great play fake right there. Boy, Bronkhorst does a great job at executing that play fake and seeing it all the way through. Slips it in to his running back, and we see the end result.
And the point after is up. And it is good. So with 8:10 to go here in the opening quarter, Genoa draws first blood as they lead this one over Lake 7-0.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
So, Cam Agler set to kick off here for Genoa as the Comets with the 7-0 lead here in quarter number one. And now that each team has had possession, what does Lake do to make any kind of adjustment here from what they were doing in their first series?
Well, you know, they can't shoot themselves in the foot, Nick. They've got to keep the chains moving.
Dar picks it up at the 7-yard line, gets it out over the 20. And is dropped at about the 24-yard line, maybe the 23, depending on the spot. But my goodness, great coverage there by the Comet special teams.
Well, you see a high kick, but watch, Jagger, Manon come in and say, get on the ground now.
Dropped him like a bad habit. Jagger Manon, he had a good game against Fostoria last week. So here we go, first and 10. It's going to be at the 23 of Lake. Well, we got a quarterback. Oh, here we go, and you got a wide open receiver downfield, net the 50 inside of Genoa territory, down all the way to the 42-yard line of Genoa. Wow. Little trick play to start this second series.
Yeah, Tobias comes in. But look, it's the whole scheme right here. He shoots down, fakes the block, and goes out, slips out in the route. Clay almost underthrew him. He's so wide open, almost could have rolled it to him. He gets it complete. Big gain for Lake, and they're in business.
That's what they needed. They needed something to answer with, and they did. So they're going to spot it. 42-yard line, first and 10. They're going to change things up here. Jay Blazevich, I believe, is in at quarterback.
Yeah, he is, Blazevich. But they're really, really letting everybody kind of tote the rubber here tonight. But I tell you, you know, that's just and that explains the slow developing play right there when you're changing too many hands in the cookie jar right now, man.
Yep, and it was. Good coverage there by the Genoa defense, which leads to a loss of four. So it's second and four. Just outside the 46. Twins out here to the right in the shotgun. Blazevich fires one down the right side, overthrows everybody as that one goes out of bounds. Yeah, Dar is his intended receiver.
Well, and that was who he was planning on throwing to when they broke the huddle as he comes out and he just kind of sails it on Dar.
Well, I stand corrected. That was Matt Perry. That was the intended receiver. So, but, yeah, it's going to be third down regardless. So it's going to be third in a mile. Well, 14 yards, only a quarter mile. Mick Mathematics, you know how that goes, Steve.
Yeah. Joseph Clay's coming in, the 5'11", 185-pound senior.
And I think the clock may have run out. The time.
We're going to get a timeout on the field.
Yeah, because the time clock was about to run out. It went to zero, but they got the timeout called. Well, we have a moment. Want to make sure we thank another one of our sponsors here with the Toledo Sports Network. That is Mr. Scott Winkowski, attorney at law. Big thank you to him as he's come on board to be part of the Toledo Sports Network family. And, of course, you know, the fun part is you know, it's a special night here in Genoa. At Jim Firestone Field, Jim and his wife, Donna, were able to come out here, and they had their family. They had a bunch of his players, former coaches that coached with him, all come out here before the game for the dedication of Jim Firestone Field. And it was just a really special moment here, and it's part of what makes Genoa football and football in the Northern Buckeye Conference so special. So it's going to be third down and 14 here for the Lake Flyers as they have it at the Genoa 46-yard line. Here's the snap. Blazevich forced out of the pocket, and he's going to get dropped at midfield.
Boy, and I tell you, coming in there rather rudely was Danny Tucholsky.
Yep.
But what they do is they push the pocket and they force him to step up, and the ends collapse. Tucholsky comes up, and he's the recipient of a real good defensive pressure on the outside.
So the ball at midfield. So it will be a fourth down kick.
Number 5.
Well, this game couldn't have started any worse for Lake. Not enough men on the field for Lake, and there's a lot of uncertainty going on right now.
And with 6:02 to go here, another timeout taken by Lake. It's still 7-0 Genoa.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality.
So here we go, fourth down, waiting the kick. Well, still a short kick. It was grabbed at the 26-yard line. Messenger gets it outside the 30. So even though it was a short return, it's still good field position here for the Comets on the short kick.
Well, early Friday night scoreboard has Eastwood over Elmwood 7-0. A lot of interesting eyes in these parts, hoping for an Elmwood victory.
Yeah, I mean, did you say Elmo?
I said Elmore. I did say Elmore.
Okay. Well, you said the R-E tacked on to Elmo.
Yeah, that's
it. We won't tickle you.
Okay.
We promise.
Please,
first and 10 here for Genoa. Brunkhorst hands the ball off, and they go up the gut. So Antry with a short pickup.
I really like the tactical change right here. Now what they're doing is just controlling the line of scrimmage. They're sending the big boys out, and they're just telling them, hey, look, go and eat. And the big fellas are getting it done. When you get 5 yards of crack, man, you're always staying ahead of the chains, and that's exactly what the Genoa Commons are doing right now.
Second down and five. Long five, short six. We'll go with five. Here's the handoff. And they break through, and my goodness, what a nice run down at the 45 of Lake.
Yeah. But look at it. Look at the blocking at the point of attack. These guys are pushing. Look at the line is pushing back into the secondary. I mean, these guys are looking for the secondary guy to hit.
Yep.
Great push right there, demonstrated by the Genoa Commons.
Allowing for an 18-yard pickup. So it's first and 10 here for the Comets. They have it at the Lake Flyer 45-yard line. Under 5 minutes to go here in this opening quarter. Brunkhorst under center. Pitches it. Gives it to Robert Messenger. Messenger driving forward. He'll be brought down just shy of the 35-yard line, it looks like.
What toss play right here. They just outflanked the Lake Flyers right here. Getting to the outside, they set the edge. Good job setting the edge. Number 12, which is Mason Drummond, does a good job at setting the edge, getting a push up the field. I'm going to bring it up second and real short.
As in less than a yard. So here we go. Ball at just between the 35 and the 36. Here's the handoff. Messenger takes it over to left tackle again. He'll drive forward, pick up the first down, and be dropped at about the 31.
Oh, sweet feet right there. Messenger, look at him right here. He picked the hole correctly. I'm going to stick my foot in the ground, and I'm going to push ahead, get all positive yards.
Approaching 4 minutes remaining here in this opening quarter. So far, it's been all Genoa. First and 10 from the Flyer 31. This is not a recording. Robert Messenger over left tackle. Able to drive forward. He'll be brought down after a pickup of about five.
Bournier did a good job at fighting off that block, man. You got to get off those blocks and shed those blocks, man. He did a good job of shedding that block right there and coming up with the tackle.
So second and five from the 26-yard line. Genoa doing this in a methodical fashion, eating up lots of clock, driving the ball. Brunkhorst under center. This time they go the right side with Antry. Antry breaks free, and he's going to take it to the house. 26 yards, touchdown, Genoa.
Once again, boy, Genoa just blocks it well here. They block this thing up so well. Look at up front. You get a pull here, and you get a push. Number 51 gets out and gets a great seal. That's Beer Bomb. He gets a great seal, opens it up. Over 90 yards rushing for Adrian Autry.
Six carries, 90 yards,
boy.
And we're not even out of the first quarter. The kick from Agler's up, and it is good. So with 2:58 to go here in the opening quarter, Genoa adds to their lead. It's 14-0.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, DiStasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike DiStasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. DiStasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
So the Comets just going about their business, and that is running the ball effectively here against Lake. Agler will go ahead and kick off again. As this one's a short. It's from the 10, and this time Dar is slammed down to the ground.
Rather rudely by Bailey Everhart.
By number 33, Bailey Everhart.
That was a nice tackle. So it's going to be first and 10 here for the Flyers. Dar has to adjust the equipment there. He took a jolting tackle there.
You know, Lake's going to have to get some kind of offensive continuity, Mick. I mean, really, right now it's been real scattered. They've showed us some offense, some of this and some of that. They're going to have to find something that's going to really work for them, because right now they're on the struggle bus, man, and if they don't get something going here, man, this could get real ugly real soon.
Well, here we go, first and 10.
13's got it.
Here's the ball handed off over here on the right side to Prophet and Savario. Picks up maybe a yard, and that's about it. Denver Stewart in on the stop.
Boy, it looked like Prophet was going to break a big one there. He just couldn't get through. You saw one of the defenders for Genoa just kind of reach up at the last moment and slow him down. A lot of linebacker to get through and knock him down.
So second and 9 here from their own 28. The Lake Flyers will send out trips to the left this time. Here's the snap. I'm going to go over here to the right. Pass is complete over there, and Matt Perry tried to go upfield, was able to pick up a little bit of real estate, but not much.
Well, you spread the field this time, Mick, and you get Perry in a one-on-one. Hey, he gets a guy to miss the tackle, and you know what happens when you miss tackles.
Yeah, I mean, it's positive yardage. That's what you got to look at mm-hmm. here if you're Lake. So it's third and 4 from their own 33. A buck 45 here to go in the quarter. And, well, they're going to go trips out left again. And that one fired over on the right side. It does not go. So it's going to be incomplete.
Beer bomb comes on an A-gap blitz, one of those fire zone reads coming up and really speeds up the progression of Blazevitz. He has to get rid of it.
Anthony Anzaldúa was their intended receiver. So that one didn't work. So Grayson Reed back in punt formation here. He's had a couple of shaky punts so far. They don't put much of a rush on him, and this time he gets a much better kick. And it's going to take a Lake bounce, and it'll be downed at the 39, and that is where Genoa will scrimmage first and 10.
Their own 39-yard line.
Oh, we have a moment. Make sure that we welcome and say thank you to Brad Morrison. Of course, we know him from Maumee Bay Turf, but also the fact that he acquired and renovated Danny's in downtown Rossford. So big tip of the cap to him. Danny's is now open for business, so a great job there by everybody. It's a beautiful facility now. If you want to go grab a ginger ale after a game, or you want to go grab something to eat and watch the game. Here we go, first and 10 from the 39.
They're going to get a false start. We got movement on along Genoa.
So it'll be first and 15 from the 34. As they will scrimmage from their own 34.
Well, Lake really needs to come up with a defensive stop here. Here's the chance you got. You have the comments behind the chains. What can you dial up defensively to kind of slow down this attack?
Yep, that's the key. And they're a young team. So they've got, you know, they've got to rely on speed here. They don't have the experience, but they've got the speed and the willingness. Here's the handoff over on the right side. Or left side, rather.
Mick, they did a better job at shedding blocks. See, as a young player, so many times what happens is you play with your hands. What you need to do is get off of blocks. You have to stunt that block at arm's length and then shed that immediately. They were able to do that in that instance. Let's see if they can continue.
Here we go, second and 13 after a pickup of 2 from Braylon Bryant. Empty backfield again. 2-3 set. Over here, fired to the left. What a snag over there by Austin Teat. Austin has been one of those guys that has slowly emerged as a clutch receiver.
Yeah, yeah, that is a clutch grab, but that, what a throw by Aiden Bronkhorst. They've worked on that. That's timing, Mick. You don't teach that right there. He knew his receiver was going to be in that spot. He threw to a spot. Because he didn't see it, he had a man barreling in on him.
Yeah, but Teat had to really stretch up to get that one. And, well, that says a lot about the combination there because Brunkhorst felt that he could. Well, Genoa's going to take a timeout here with 37 seconds remaining. And while we have the timeout, we'll take a moment. And we will say thank you to another one of our sponsors, Tas Electronics. Always a pleasure. They've been around with us for a long time. And, well, we're always grateful whenever they come on board and they know what we're trying to do here, and they are a big backers of us, so we really do thank them. And don't forget, too, if you want to join us as far as being a sponsor here of the Toledo Sports Network, we've got advertising packages that are good for any budget. So they fit any budget. So you can give Mike Jamison a call at 419-514-1302. That's 419-514-1302. And Mike Jamison will be able to help you out with getting the word out about your business and our gigantic footprint. First and 10 from the 49-yard line of Genoa. Brunkhorst under center. And here we go. Here's the pitch. And Messenger fights his way through, and he's going to pick up a first down and then some.
Oh, my goodness. Did you see
he ran
Caleb
violently.
Get us? Caleb took his man and blocked him 15 yards down the field. Man, big fellas don't get called out unless they're holding all the time. This big fella got it done.
Well, that's what it's going to be about here, too. Don't forget, we got one more play to go here, what should be the final play of the opening quarter.
Pick up your $100 at the Booster Barn.
Antry keeps going. He gets outside, and nice pickup again.
that left tackle is getting it done for Genoa. My goodness, he is putting in work.
Well, the key is, too, is the fact that, well, we'll get into that more as we go because that is the end of the first quarter. So we've got one in the books here from Jim Firestone Field in Genoa, inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. And, well, the Comets are serving it up as they lead it 14-0.
Two NBC co-athletes of the year and one state qualifier. In the high jump, Lillian Frias jumped 5'3", breaking a 40-year-old school record of 5'2". That was set by Jody Donnelly in 1982 and matched by Stacy Krieger in 2001. Lillian was also an indoor state qualifier in the high jump. Presenting Lillian with her award are the former record holders Jody Donnelly and Stacy Krieger McDaniel. The boys 4x200 meter relay team had a tremendous year, breaking the school record a total of four times and becoming the first boys short sprint relay team to qualify for the regionals in school history. By the end of the season, the final record mark of 130.28 lowered the previous record set in 2021 by over 2 seconds. Relay team members are Aiden Hemmer, Jacob Stahl, Ethan Wilson, and Aiden Antry. Presenting the team with the commemorative baton is head coach Luke.
Second quarter of football getting ready to start. As Genoa driving as they lead at 14-0, and they have it first and 10 at the Flyer 21. This time around, Brunkhorst airs it out. He's got a receiver, and it's good for the touchdown. 21 yards, touchdown Genoa.
But
Mason Drummond hauls it in for 6.
Brunkhorst did a great job of just executing that play fake all the way out. He throws it to the back pylon, to the back end line, to where only his guy can get it. Man, what a great throw. Excellently done.
Yep, one-on-one coverage, and he just Drummond was able to separate, get enough separation. Hagler puts it up, and it is true. So, with 11:55 to go here in the first half, Genoa opens up a 21-0 lead.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, Mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's. 419-698-1641.
Ethan and Aiden, legend
on
the first Eastwood Seven. In track and field, school history in 2021. Congratulations, Ethan Wilson and Aiden.
Well, it's been all Genoa thus far here tonight as the Comets with a lead of 21-0. I am Mick. He is Steve. Don't forget, coming up later, we're going to have the Taylor Kia family, Taylor Automotive family. Taylor Automotive Unsung Hero Award. There you go. We'll have that one coming up here later on in the ball game. And I think an early nominee is going to be the people that have to help me to learn to talk English. Hagler. Another short kick as it's picked up by Dar, and they'll get it out to about the 25-yard line. And he was brought down by Magnone as the Flyers looking for answers here. But it's back to the chalkboard. They're going to spot the ball at the, well, let's see, the 20, looks like the 27, it looks like they're going to spot that ball. So first and 10 for Lake.
Friday night scoreboard, Elmwood leading Eastwood 14-7. In the second quarter. Six is under
center. Here's the handoff now, taking it around is Ethan Bradfield. Bradfield is going to be dropped after a pickup of, well, let's see, maybe a yard.
Yeah, well, Messenger and company came over, and they really did a good job at stringing that out. They didn't allow any running lanes.
Time for an injury. We got an injured player on the field here as they'll stop the clock. Yep, with 11:28.
Over the summer, the Genoa Comet football program held its annual 3-day.
Well, you know, the other thing too, don't forget, if you are in the Toledo area, or even if you're not, you can do it online. Be sure to tune in to the sports show that sucks each and every Saturday morning from 8 to 10 on ESPN 100.7 The Ticket.
Fourth grade, Mason Fisher. Fifth grade,
of course, that
Drew Nutter.
Well, let's
Sixth
see
grade,
here.
Seth Giddes.
Looks
Seventh
like
grade, Hunter
Mason able to
Eighth grade, Colby
get Charleston off the field fine.
The overall winner with a
so it'll be first and 10 here for Lake. And
the three events.
We've said it's back to the drawing board here for the Flyers. Second down and 10. Here's the handoff again over there for a profit, and Savario picks up a good chunk of yardage. You'll see where they spot the ball at. It looks like it's going to be at the 35.
Well, Denver Stewart did a great job at tackling in space, really cutting down the ball carrier.
So it's going to make it third down and 2. So it's a very attainable goal here for the Flyers. You're not looking to score every, you know, score it all in one bunch in one play. So just work on the first down here. Third and 2. So it's profit. Wow, Profit gets it. A great run there for Savario as he was able to take it out near midfield.
Boy, this time Clay runs the speed option and really gets the defense to move, and that's what they want. They got the defense to move. They were able to get to the edge. Profit right there with speed, getting to the edge.
Yep, so it's going to be first and 10 here for the Flyers at midfield. Clock is stopped for the moment with 10:21. And here we go. And this time the Genoa defense says not so fast.
Yeah, doing a good job at crashing down was
Number 52, Donnie Tucholsky.
Tucholsky was one of the first ones there. 62 was there too, Braden Meffrin. They really did a good job of just collapsing that and saying, hey, look, not today, not on my watch.
Loss on the play of, I believe, a yard. So second and 11. Trips out to the left. Lazovich throws it and overthrows his intended target.
Blazevich's
pass is intended for Blazevich not able to step into that. That was an all-arm throw right there. And consequently, the ball sails on him. The rush for the Comets not allowing him to step into that pass.
So it's going to be third down and 11. That stops the clock with 9:40 to go here in the first half.
But it's to give the rush man a chance to get after the quarterback here.
Will they have a meeting at the quarterback? It remains to be seen. Here's the snap. Glazevich fires it over the middle. It's intercepted at the 37-yard line. Brought over now and brought into deep into Lake territory.
Intercepted by number 12.
And that's Mason
Drummond.
Yep, Mason Drummond hauls it in.
But Drummond had a beat on that because Glazevich, he had locked in on one receiver the entire way, and Drummond just honed in on it, stepped in front of it, and we see the end result.
Yep, that's what, that's the break that, that's the type of break that, you know, every defender looks for, you know. I mean, when you are looking at that quarterback, you're looking them all the way in.
Well, Mick, you know, as a defender, you know that they've got to go 12 yards. So as a defender, you only drift back as far as the stick, and that's exactly what he did. It gives you a chance to break on the ball. You keep everything in front of you, you know. What we used to say, me and Kaz Merrick, we used to say, nothing deep, nothing cheap. And that's exactly what's the mentality right there.
Yep, so it's a nice pickoff there by the Comets. They'll have it first and 10 at the Lake 33-yard line.
John Church and Wilson will be donating a $25 sack of groceries to the Genoa Food Pantry.
My goodness, it's
Genoa.
I mean, you couldn't ask for a better night. Not only a beautiful night for football, but the dedication here of Jim Firestone Field to honor a legendary coach who coached for years here. He wasn't even originally from here. He was originally from, I believe, Pennsylvania. And came here. And it was, you know, started as an assistant for a few years. Went on to become the head coach. And then went on quite the run. Most winningest coach in Genoa history. I believe 109 wins. Not too shabby.
Well, let's see if Genoa continues to run behind the left side of that line. It's had a lot of success in doing so.
Here's the. Okay, Brunkhorst going to throw it deep. He's got a receiver. And it's hauled in there by Denver Stewart for the touchdown. 33 yards, touchdown, Genoa.
That's a man's throw. That's a man's throw, Mick. He stepped in there. He does a great job at airing it out. And that's throwing it back to the other side. So that's going all the way across the field. So that's a strong throw right there by that kid.
Yep. Great job of Maiden Brunkhorst to Denver Stewart, 33 yards. Aguilar, high snap. Kick gets off. And they miss the point after. So, with 9:21 to go here, Genoa pouring it on as it is 27-0.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio.
A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned.
To make the stadium look great. Thank you to the press box committee of Kim Traver, Blake Traver, Bob Yonker, Shelley Long.
Oh, the Comets doing everything right except for the point after there. They have been dominating here over Lake.
Jason Maglin, Jeff Cooper, Tom.
Well, really clicking on all cylinders offensively, and then from a defensive standpoint, you've really been able to implement your principles and really, really perform at a high level.
Oh, my goodness. Dar could not, took too long to decide what they were going to do. And next thing you know, he got ate up big time from Bailey Everhart.
Actually, that was Dylan Wright on that affair trying to get on the outside. And Joseph Gray tried to set a block, and boy, almost kind of blocked his own teammate down.
Yep, so it'll be first and 10 here. From the, well, let's see where they're spotting that ball. It looks like the 13-yard line, it looks like. So it'll be first and 10.
First and 10 from the Flyers.
So first and 10 here for Lake. 9:17 to go in the half.
That's not going to be, it's going to be an incomplete pass.
That one just did not go well. It was doomed from the start.
Well, short option pass, what it, you know, it, what in the past would have been conceived a running play is now considered a pass play, but.
Mm-hmm. So regardless, it's second and 10.
And the quarterback shuffle continues. It's Blazevich this time.
Yep. 13. So they hand the ball off to Prophet. Prophet will drive forward. He was dropped by Denver Stewart, who's having a pretty darn good game here tonight as well.
Well, the big fellas in front of Denver Stewart are really eating up blocks. They're doing a good job at eating up blocks, allowing him to get there. Carson Grauman, he's up there really, really occupying the offensive line for the Lake Flyers and allowing his linebackers to come up and make plays, and that's exactly what the Comet linebackers are doing.
So it will be third down after no gain. In the shotgun. Quarterback draw, and that one doesn't go very far. Maybe 2 yards, maybe three. So it'll be fourth down again, punting situation here for Lake. So it was a wall of maroon that brought down the.
It was, Nick. It was just that. But they've really controlled the line of scrimmage on both sides. Them being the Lake, the Genoa Comets.
Reed just gets that one off, and it'll be a fair caught ball at the 41-yard line of Lake.
So once again, the Comets in great field position as they'll start on Flyer
41
side of the field.
Yep, 41-yard line, first and 10. And And Bronkhorst still in there at quarterback.
And then going back to the spread. So once again, here's another change.
Yep. 3-2. Empty backfield. Bronkhorst gets fours. The pass falls incomplete. He wanted Mason Drummond over there, but he was rushed there.
Yeah, well, you know, what the philosophy is to catch him on the smoke screen, to kind of let him in. This time the Lake Flyers got in too fast. They tried to sneak Drummond out behind that rush and get a wall of blockers behind him.
Second and 10 here from the 41. This time they go trips to the right, two to the left. Bronkhorst with more time to throw. Pass is complete. And it's going to be, I believe, Robert Messenger.
Look, this is not Bronkhorst's original read. Look at him. That's his original read was covered. He comes back to his secondary read to Messenger. That is great football application right there. This kid understands what he's doing. He's not being rushed. He is doing exactly what he's supposed to do.
So it's first and 10 here for the Comets from the 29-yard line. Here's the snap. Bronkhorst looking downfield. He's going to a short pass over here on the right side. And that was Antry who dropped it.
Yeah, if you notice, this pass is thrown a little bit behind Antry. What he wants to do is Bronkhorst would like to get this out in front of him and let him run with the ball. He threw it behind him. Antry is moving across the field, and he's moving rather rapidly. It's kind of tough if you don't put that directly on him.
Oh, it's going to make it second and 10. Clock stops with 7:14 to go. Here's another dart wide open over here on the right side. Drummond fighting his way through. He'll pick up a first down. And no move the sticks.
Boy, you talk about having a great grasp of the offense. Goes right to his initial read. Finds Drummond. Knows he's there. Good job at Genoa moving the pocket.
So it'll be first and 10 from the 12. Under 7 minutes to go here in the opening half.
That's an interesting matchup over there, Prophet and Drummond.
We'll see what happens here.
Prophet is up in press coverage.
1 second on the timeout. Oh, timeout taken by Genoa. I think that maybe Coach Fisher thought that they weren't going to get the playoff in time, but they did. But they'll take the timeout here with 6:40 to go here in the first half.
Graymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamite Lime and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
Guarantees he's going to come back for his field dedication. So the Comets again threatening here, first and 10 from the 12. They've been successful every trip in the red zone thus far. Bronkhorst over here to the right side.
Touchdown. He's in.
Well,
he's in.
They're going to say out of bounds. My goodness.
Yeah, that's a great route concept, man. From the slot, you see, from the slot, he goes to the outside, back foot hits, ball is out. Let's see if this is indeed out of bounds.
Alex Spencer only needs 1 foot.
That's
close. You be the judge. That was close.
I'm going with the guys in up here that said that he caught the ball. Look
well,
at
he
it.
He caught the ball. Just a question of whether or not he was in.
I see that toe looks like it's on the line.
Okay. Well, here we go. Back to live action. And this time around, It's caught for a touchdown. 12 yards, touchdown, Genoa. This time it's Austin Teat hauling it in. And that is a Genoa Bank touchdown.
Well, Austin pulls in another one. Boy, this kid's got good touch on it, good feathery touch. I like the spread aspect of the game. You know, I like how they change up the tempo and they'll slow it down and they'll get after you and run the football. Pretty impressed with this addition of Genoa.
Agler tacks on the point after. So with 6.5 to go here in the half, Genoa pouring it on as they are now up out in front, 34-0.
Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa, has been serving the area with quality jewelry and gifts for over 19 years. Specializing in gold and silver repairs, Frank Comeyes has been a goldsmith for over 30 years. Our selection of Pulsar watches, Precious Moments figurines, Reflections beads, Seraphim classics, and quality Stellar rings, all at a price you can afford. Genoa Jewelers also buys gold and silver and has the perfect gift for that someone special. Stop out today at Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa.
Brandon Dar, Ian Ferris,
Agler
kickoff for the Comets.
Genoa fans sitting pretty happy right now. As they lead Lake. Cam Agler's been a busy boy here tonight.
Well, I tell you, he'll sleep well tonight.
Another chip shot going to be grabbed at about the 20. Oh, boy, here we go. Good return here by the Flyers. So,
Ian Ferris on the return.
So the kicker brought him down. So, first and 10, Lake Flyers. They will scrimmage from their own 47-yard line. So good field position here for them. Joe Clay in there at quarterback this time. Profit goes and is drilled back. He's driven back.
Well, not a lot of continuity for the Lake offense as it continues to ride the struggle bus.
Bearbaum and Tucholsky in on the stop there for the Comets.
I mean, they're just blowing it up before they even get started.
Loss of two, second down, second and 12 from the 45.
But you see the uncertainty in the Lake offense, even from the snap of the ball. It's like the quarterback almost hesitates from the snap.
Well, here we go. There's Clay going around the right side.
Joseph Clay.
That's a design quarterback draw.
So a pickup of about 4 yards, so it will be third down and 8.
That's been the story of the game for the Lake Flyers, third and long. They really can't escape third and long.
Well, they need to get it to the 43 of Genoa.
It's a 3-by-1 set.
Mm-hmm. Clay tosses it out to the left side. They pick up the first down as they're into Genoa territory and brought down at just inside the 40-yard line.
Good job at Profit picking up the blitz, giving enabling his quarterback to turn and throw and find the receiver.
Yep, Dar, the receiver, was able to haul it in. Took a belt, though, and he was kind of... I won't say doubled over, but he's not feeling too swift in that huddle.
Getting up, definitely.
Let's see if the Flyers, what they can do here. First and 10 from the 40, 4:40 to go here in the half. So now Profit around the right side. He's got a block, able to pick up the first down, gets outside, and then finally brought down. He's forced out at about the 21.
Well, that's all. That's just one of those speed handoffs that you utilize in profit speed. But number 72 for the Lake Flyers did a good job. That's Cody Capoletti. Capoletti gets out and really kind of leads that thing for him.
So a pickup of 19 there for profit. That's a first down here. It's the deepest that Lake has been able to penetrate here into Genoa territory so far this ball game. Here now, Profit goes to left side, flag on the play. This one's coming back. Pickup of maybe 2 yards, but it's going to come back.
Yeah, Genoa just wouldn't be outflanked. That we'll get a block in the back here. It's going to bring it back, but Lake tried to utilize the same play to the other to the left side this time.
Holding against the Flyers.
So they will bring it back.
Yeah, that's going to be a block in the back. That's that's 15 yards, brother.
So. And all is said and done, it's a first and 24 here for the Flyers. And boy, oh boy, just again, one step forward, two steps back. No, backwards lateral. How do you like that little dipsy-do? Pick up a lot of yardage there. It worked out. It was a reversal there. We take a look right here. Clay
hadn't gone up. That's good. He hadn't gone over the line. That was good.
So, second and 13. So they pick up a good chunk of real estate. Clock continues to run.
Nothing there. Nothing there.
That was just doomed from the word go. So Shapila in on the stop, but my goodness.
Shapila just destroyed the line of scrimmage. He just totally blew that up on that left side.
Third and 14, the ball at the Genoa 25-yard line. Oh, here we go. In the shotgun. Clay dishes it off here to Profit. Profit has an edge, but great recovery and tackle as he was dropped just that quick.
Watch Alex Spencer come up, yep, shooting from his safety spot. Watch him come up and close. This is how you cut down a ball carrier in space.
And he did so there, right? He just took him down. So it is going to be fourth and 10. So the clock will be stopped here with 2:24 to go here in the opening half.
I don't know what the discussion is in the late huddle with the official.
Nope. The play clock hasn't started, and the game clock hasn't started. Looks like they're finally going to get things started. So here we go. Fourth down and 10. The ball at the 21. Twins on each side.
Run.
And it's fired over here to the left side, incomplete. That was a tough break there. It was intended there for Nathan Wagner. And, well, it's just kind of been the luck of the Flyers here all night tonight.
They really, really come up short on that one. Good job out of Genoa defense putting out that attempt there. And let's see if they continue to spread it out. It looks like they're going to continue to spread it out. They've had a lot of success they've had a lot of success in everything they've done offensively.
Well, that's true. Let's see if they can what they can do here with the 2-minute offense or the 207 offense, as it were.
Genoa employing another 3-by-2 set. They've been putting stress on those defensive backs and see if they can continue to do that.
We're on course. He's very comfortable operating in that empty backfield. He's going to look, throw, he's going to go for the home run. He's got Drummond on the fly, in flight. Beautiful grab. Drag down here into Lake Territory at approximately the 30, looks like they'll spot him at the 36.
It's just a seam route. I mean, Genoa understands that they're playing zone. They're seeing exclusive zones, and the quarterback is doing a great job at just exploiting the zones.
44-yard pickup. Here's the pass on the right side, and Drummond hauls it in again.
I mean, the defensive backs of Lake are just giving away yards. I mean, they're real, real soft coverage.
Well, Genoa all of a sudden going from deep in their own end to threatening here again. Second down and two, the ball at the 28 of Lake. 1:46 to go here in the opening half. Here now is Bronkhorst. Fires it over here on the right side. Enough for the first down here for Alex Spencer.
Spencer just running the out route from the slot. He's just really taking what the defense is giving him. Aiden doing a great job of exploiting that.
Yep. And good clock management, too. He doesn't have to, but in terms of getting the repetitions in and learning how to run a two-minute offense, he's doing a great job with it. Two to the left, three to the right. Brunkhorst looking towards the end zone. Led that receiver a little too far.
Boy, timing off on that one. Good job at Lake, D'ing that one up. See Dar over there in defense. Dar's done a good job in his defensive techniques. He really doesn't get stressed and he doesn't get out of position often.
So it will be second and 10 here. Wrong course. He'll try it again. And it is just a little bit off. So Austin Teat unable to haul that one in. I'll stop the clock with 1:33 to go.
You just basically run the fade. From the 3-by-2 set, they really kind of caught the Lake defense napping a bit. But you got the size with Dar over there against Teat.
Well, here we go, third and 10. His third time the charm. Brunkhorst going again.
This time he threw the fade from the slot. Good job in defending it.
Well, too good, actually, from Dar, because it was Messenger, the intended receiver, and there's a flag. So it's going to be a PI against Lake. So it'll be first down. Automatic first down here for the Comets as they will spot the ball at the 9. It'll be first and goal.
No, it's not first and goal. It's not automatic first down.
Oh, wait a minute. I stand corrected. That is actually
third and 1.
I'm sorry. I apologize for that. I just thought with the PI that would be an automatic first, but it's not. It's actually.
And they go up under center. This is a ball.
Yep, third and a yard.
Power game.
Messenger driving forward, and he's going to take it.
Yeah, but we're going to get a flag right there. I think this one's going to come back. I think this one may be holding. I think this is going to go against Genoa.
Oh, wait. Yep, you called it there, partner. That one's coming back. So, went from third and one to when, how long is this trip inside the red zone going to take?
Yeah, this is going to go back 10 yards. Boy, good job, but, you know, recognizing that the left side of their offensive line has really been the heavy lifters, and they went to run on that side, and that side did a good job. But, unfortunately, the holding penalty came from the right side of the offensive line.
So it'll be 3rd and 6 from the 14. Here's Messenger. He's going to run forward, and he's just going to—he's going to be just shy of the goal line, I think.
Boy, you see how strong he is. He was stopped dead to right. You see him right here in the hole. You see him keep his feet, pick it up, and then power in for almost a touchdown. It's just short of the goal line.
So it'll be 1st and goal. This time I am sure of that from the 1. I'm so used to college and pro, when you throw into the end zone and it's a PI, it just automatically goes.
Not necessarily, especially even in college. It's not necessarily a first down, depending on down and distance.
Yep. And this time around, Robert Messenger takes it to the house as it is a Genoa touchdown.
Left side of the line, just too much. Getting it done makes it look easy.
So a 1 yard run there by Messenger.
How many yards we got, Robert?
Oh, you're 336.
Check your numbers, you're wrong.
I know, that's why I like playing.
And the kick is up and good from Agler. So with 50 seconds left here in the half, it's all Genoa, 41-0.
Genoa Comets, 41. The Lake Flyers, 0.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Well, Genoa doing everything right here tonight. And you know it's a rough night as this one is short kick. Picked up at the 26 over there by, I believe that was Kohlhofer. So, tell you, the reason I say, you know, it's not a good night for Lake is we're not even at halftime and fans are actually leaving from Lake.
Not a good look right now. Offensively, they've really been on the struggle bus, and that's putting it kindly.
If they were going to the concession stand, I'd say okay. But the problem is, I can see the concession stand from here, and they're not going there. They're bypassing that. They are not stopping at Go or collecting $200. Now here's Profit. He's trying to get a spark going here for the Flyers. As he is dropped.
By number 51, Zach Beerbaum.
Beerbaum's had himself a night here so far. Him and Denver Stewart. Stewart's done it both sides of the football.
Well, it's been one impressive outing.
Yep.
Thus far for Genoa.
And still got to pick the unsung hero here from Taylor Automotive. Well, they're not going to stop the clock, so they may not. Well, they'll get one more snap, maybe. Nope, they're going to let it go to 0.
Yeah.
So we got one half in the books here at Jim Firestone Field inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. And it's been all Comets here as they lead this one. As we head to the half, it is the Genoa Comets 41, the Lake Flyers nothing.
Blackberry Corner on the corner of 579 and Elliston Road is a proud sponsor of Genoa football and has the best burgers, chicken, and pizza. You know the pizza. Everyone knows the pizza. Blackberry Corner also has charbroiled pork ribs and Jim's famous chicken dinners. Whether it's appetizers, pizza, or a full dinner, the great folks at Blackberry Corner can help fill you up and save you money. Stop out to Blackberry Corners on the corner of State Route 579 and Elliston Road for a meal or just a snack. You've planned and planned. Each moment of your special day just has to be perfect. You don't want to worry about anything. Just know that you've hired professionals to make your wedding day special. Mike Jamison with Creative Video Imagery has produced award-winning weddings for over 15 years. Our company has the equipment and the artistic ability to capture your day on digital DVD, giving you lasting memories of a day you will cherish forever. Call Creative Video Imagery today or visit our website, Creative Video Imagery, making moments into lifetime memories.
With the big box stores, choose Gladio.
Hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned. You'll be glad to know. Gladio, Gladio Home Center.
Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street, right next to Nick and Jimmy, with top-of-the-line golf simulators, duckpin bowling, and the best food for your night out. We've got you covered. It's Pro Golf Fairways with all the greatest golf courses in the area. Why not come out and hit a few with us at Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street, next to Nick and Jimmy.
It's not too early to start thinking about updating your boat or motorcycle with a new sound system. Get custom marine sound system installations for just about anything that floats. And enjoy the open road with motorcycle head unit and sound system upgrades from TAS. Fast, expert installation from the area's leader in connected mobile technology.
TAS Electronics. You know. TAS Electronics. It's hot.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244-LEAK-Seagate.
At Genoa Custom Interiors, we provide quality service at competitive prices. We offer a variety of flooring and interior design options customized to fit your needs. From carpets to hardwood, no matter what type of flooring you desire, we have what you want. Our designers will show you how to set up furniture, flooring, window treatments. Contact us today for a free estimate for any of our interior design, installation, and services. Genoa Custom Interiors.
Getting ready for the third quarter here at Genoa. I tell you, it's been an entertaining football game if you're from Genoa. On the lakeside of things, not so much. It's 41-0. The Comets lead the Flyers as we get ready to start quarter number three. I am Mick Gonzalez. He is Steve Taylor. We've got, of course, Curtis on high camera, Carlos on low camera, and in the production truck. Trying to make the symphony make sense is Mr. Mike Jamison.
Who was that in the truck again?
Mr. Mike Jamison, okay. As we like to say. Anyhow. Yes, I thought I could hear you back there. Anyway, Steve, Well, I guess, you know, I mean, we're going to start the second half here with a running clock. It is not, I mean, what do you do if you're late to try to make the game respectable?
Well, really, you just got to find some kind of continuity. And we're going to start on the defensive side of the ball. I mean, the zone principles are not working, you know. So I imagine you're going to get a heavy dose of the jumbo package. So, you know, I would really expect to see a lot of the safeties cheating down and try to help out, try to plug some of these running lanes.
So Antry picks up the ball at the 5-yard line. He will run the ball forward. It'd be brought down approximately the 26-yard line. We'll see where they spot that ball. But it will be first and 10 here for the Comets. And again, as we said, as you can see, it's a running clock. So anything in the state of Ohio for football, if you're over 35 points and over, thank you. 30 points and over, it is a running clock.
So we've got a different quarterback in for Genoa. It'll be Braylon Bryant.
We have not seen that. Not gotten to see him too much. They're going to run the wing T here to start. Antry will take the ball, go over to right tackle, and he will drive forward.
Antry, over 100 yards rushing in that first half. He had 109 yards rushing, a couple of touchdowns.
Well, it's been a... Well, it's been one of those things where everyone who's touched the ball tonight for Genoa has been successful. So here we go, second down and 4. Bryant hands the ball off to Messenger. Messenger drives forward. He'll be close to a first down. We'll see, depending on the spot, he may be... Well, it looks like they're moving the chains.
Yeah, they're going to move the chains. I tell you, this time they try the right side of that offensive line, and they're starting to get pushed from there. They've buttered their bread from the left side of the line, been dominant on that side.
So it's first and 10 here. They'll spot the ball right at the 36-yard line. And again. Oh, looks like, is that Brunkhorst back under center? And that ball is handed off, and over on the left side, off they go.
And it's going to be a late flag, and this is going to come back. We're going to get a late holding call.
Well, if there's anything that I'm and you know how coaches are, Steve, the one thing about coaches is that they always find a reason to gripe about something. You could win 100-0, and they'll still find a reason to gripe about something you did wrong.
Yeah.
And thinking in Coach Fisher's kid and the whole coaching staff here for Genoa, I think it's going to be penalties. They've only had a couple.
But they've been timely.
They've been very untimely. So. Holding fellows blocking the back when they holding. So, it'll be first and 16 from the 30-yard line. Messenger trying to get around the corner, cannot, as he is brought down just shy of the line of scrimmage, as Matt Perry was the guy that was right there to bring him down.
Well, Anthony Andazula did a good job at setting the edge and really forcing that back the other way.
Well, they're going to say a loss of a yard, so it'll be second down and 17. The ball at the 29. Mm-hmm. Now we got a procedure penalty going to be called here, I think, against Genoa. Boy, oh boy.
With too many men on the field, it looks like, you know.
You can have too many
men. Illegal substitution, too many men on the field. I believe that one of the Genoa players tried to get off late. And yep, boy, so the Scott Bulldogs are putting it on tonight. They are laying it out 68-0. How about them Bulldogs?
Who are they playing? Well, here we go as Messenger goes. Able to haul that one in, and it'll be close to a first down, making up a lot of yardage. As Garcia brought him down, but, well, I should say the original line of scrimmage, as it is third down and 10. They're in the shotgun. Some pressure as it's fired over here. Oh, in and out of the hands of Mason Drummond.
That's Brandon Darr not panicking. What I want you to watch Darr close on this. He comes over and he breaks that up. That's a great job not stressing when the ball is in the air. So many times you see young DBs stress when the ball is in the air. He did a great job at finding the ball and breaking it up.
Not stress it when everyone else is messing. Well, he's going to be back there.
Evan Milner
going to get some time in here to kick for Genoa. As the short kick takes the Genoa bounce, though. And it will be down at approximately the 33-yard line, I believe, or 32. Looks like the 32. So it will be first and 10 here for the Lake Flyers. 36. So that'll stop the clock, as you see right there, with 5:54 to go.
And it gets even worse for Scott, as they're up 76-0, and the recipient of that beating would be the Bowser Rebels.
Yep, I thought so. I knew you were hesitant about that, but that's okay.
Yeah, I remember.
You remember the days. Here now is Profit. He is deep, maybe the line of scrimmage.
There was a trip we made to Lima. We played Lima Senior. Mm-hmm. We happened to lose that game at the exact same score of our game at this time.
41-0?
And everything that week was 41. It was 41 push-ups. It was 41 jumping jacks. It was 41 sprints. Everything was 41.
Oh, boy. I'm so glad I didn't play football when you were there. Well, here we go. Second, they're going to give him a yard. Second and 9. Here is Profit. They're able to pick up a first down and more as he takes it up near midfield, maybe over midfield. We'll see where they spot it.
Well, you know, Profit has been the one bright spot for Lake as he gets to the outside. They're utilizing that little speed handoff there. And letting him just get to the edge, utilizing his athleticism.
Well, don't forget, we've got the Taylor Automotive family 42-34. Unsung hero of the game.
Now, is that something that we pick or what?
Yes, and it's not the star of the game.
Because I got a guy that I am just totally just head over heels over right now.
Again, it's the unsung hero of the game, not the star of the game.
And he's an unsung hero, all right.
All right, well, here we go as it goes up the gut, and they get it to about the 46 of Genoa. So it'll be second and 6. Clock continues to run as we're under 4 minutes. Don't forget, this is a running clock.
Eastwood 42, Elmwood 34, third quarter.
Eastwood leading Elmwood 43-34.
Well, it's going to be a big battle in the NBC here between those two. Profit goes
ahead,
up the gut.
Nothing doing. Closing the door once again. It's my guy who's had what a heck of a game, Caleb Geddes. Oh, my goodness. The big fellow really getting it done on both sides of the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's going to make it third down and 6 after no gain.
There was no gain on the play. Third quarter score from Campbellville, Eastwood 42, Elmwood 34.
And here we go now. 3 minutes to go in the quarter. Here's the snap. Quarterback keeper. It looks like it's going to be a first down, or close to it.
Boy, Lake did a good job of just getting him blocked up front this time.
You look right there, and Denver Stewart runs him out, but not before moving the sticks.
Oh, the big fellas did a good job at making the defensive line for Genoa occupy blocks there.
And the thing that's kind of made me go, is the two. Well, here's the snap. We'll get into that in here in a little bit. Pocket is flushed, and oops, Tucholsky knocks him down.
Tucholsky accidentally got that sack, people. I tell you, he just runs right into Tucholsky. And boy, was that a violent collision.
Yeah, when you're going up against someone who's a lot bigger than you are, it doesn't work well.
We'll make a $25 donation to the General Food Pantry for the sack groceries.
So it's second and 16 after that loss of six. You know, at the 46. Here's Profit, and wow. You don't try to run that direction till the next quarter. That was just not. Jagger Magnon was in on the stop on that after Magnon. A loss of four.
Totally defeated the guard on there. Just totally, just. Shedded him, and he did a good job at pushing that running play to the outside, setting up a second and long.
Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. It's third and 20 from midfield. I think it's safe to say it's a passing situation here. Just call me crazy, but no. And instead, it's going to be a tackle.
And right on cue, Gittes. Right on cue, does a great job.
Technically, it's not a sack because it wasn't for lost.
So
it's going to be fourth and 20 from midfield. And there's. I was going to say that I think this should be that should have been the last play unless they punt it. But there's a 3-second difference between the game clock and the time clock, and he doesn't have to snap the ball. But they're going to. Line drive picked up at its 23.
Messenger
keeps moving forward. He's driving, and takes it all the way to about the 44-yard line. And that is where Genoa will scrimmage first and 10 when we start the fourth quarter. The Comets and the Flyers is Genoa 41, Lake 0.
The Lake Flyers.
Hey, everybody, it's Steve Taylor from the Taylor Automotive Family. It is September, and that means it is Free Car Friday. All month long, we're giving away another vehicle at the end of this month, and you can be the lucky winner this month. We've already given away six fantastic vehicles this year. This month, we're going to change things up a little bit. We're having a scavenger hunt. You can get a golden ticket anywhere in Northwest Ohio. We'll be out and about in the communities, Toledo, Perrysburg, Findlay, Lima. We will have some of our people out in the communities. We'll let you know on Facebook where we'll be. We'll give you clues, and all you have to do is come up and get one of those golden tickets, and that means you got a chance to win this fantastic vehicle in September. It is simple, but don't forget, you got to go to our Facebook page, you got to like, comment, and share on that pinned post. It is that easy. Have some fun in September. Be on the lookout for the golden ticket, and maybe you can win that new car. We'll see you. Have a good one.
View at 4 p.m. Boys soccer will host Allen East at 6 p.m. Freshman JV University volleyball.
Of course, we always are grateful to the Taylor Automotive family for sponsoring the unsung hero of the game. We'll have to pick that one in a little quicker than normal because we've got a running clock here as we start the fourth quarter. 41-0 Genoa.
Which qualified them to compete in districts next Thursday at Eagles Landing. Congratulations to the Comet Boys golf team.
Brock Matthews is in at quarterback.
So, you can hear it right there. Brock Matthews in at quarterback, as that one was handed off to Hunter Teat. And
apparently flag on the play. It looks like preliminary indication is going to be holding. because now you have a different line in now as Genoa continues to substitute freely.
Mm-hmm. All the younger players getting a chance to play.
Caleb Johnson.
And of course,
$100 down at the booster barn. Thank you.
It doesn't get easier for Josh Andrews and the Lake Flyers as next week they're at home to Elmwood.
Holding on us, fellas.
Holding on us.
And I know that for Genoa, they've got Otsego next week. So lots of entertaining football coming up here.
Well, Genoa's put a lot on tape for Otsego to try to
grasp,
figure out what the heck they're going to do. It's, the run game is a handful, and then when you load the box, man, they'll spread you out, and they'll search for mismatches, man. They look to put defensive backs, man, in really, really critical situations to where it's a snap judgment, you know. And if you blow your assignment, man, these guys are really good at exploiting that.
Making you pay. So it's going to be second and 18. Ball at the 35 of Genoa.
R.J. Atkins.
Here now is R.J. Atkins going around the right side. It'll be dropped at the 40.
He's cut down nicely by Darren Miller.
So it sets up third down and long, third and 14. They'll spot the ball at the 39, so.
They'll probably let Robson the quarterback the next series.
As I said, the Comets letting a lot of the youth play here.
Rock fling it up.
Looks like it.
Third and 14. Empty the backfield.
Here's the snap. They're going to throw it out here. That one goes incomplete.
Rock Matthews pass.
So Matthews,
for number six, Luke Clemens.
He was looking for incomplete. Luke Clemens, but could not get him to. 14. Couldn't complete the pass play, so it'll be.
Into punt for the Comets, number 53.
It's going to bring up fourth down, and you could just see the chemistry not there on that offering.
Felipe Garcia. For number one, Brandon Darr.
So. Clock continues to run here, as we said, no stopping the clock.
Perrysburg leave Anthony Wade 24-21.
And now we've got a flag on the play here.
Boy, that's really good. Those are the type of things that really burns a coach's stole right there, you know.
That will stop the clock here, a change of possession.
It was a penalty out there.
And we'll see what. Motion. So illegal motion is going to be the call here against Genoa.
They declined it?
I don't know. I think it should.
Well, it looks like Lake is going to decline the penalty.
No, maybe not.
Well, I stand corrected. They're standing. All their guys are standing over near the 27-yard line.
They just want the ball, man. They don't want to punt it again.
The players want to decline it, but I think Josh Andrews, let's see what's going on here. Well, the referee picks up the flag now, so it looks like it's going to be declined after all.
Maybe we'll get an explanation. I don't know.
I doubt it. But we do need to pick a
Well, I tell you who I like. I like Caleb Giddes, the big fella, 6'6", 238-pound offensive defensive lineman. The junior lineman really was getting it done. That's who I like.
Okay. And I will go with for Lake. I'll take Mr. Darr on defense. He was getting it done and had breaking up plays. Giving his team opportunities, but it just didn't fall for them. So Clay carries the ball, and he's brought down by Atkins, a pickup of about five. Nice big chill Nice big chill in the air here as we are under 8 minutes to go in this one. Big thank you to our cameramen. I'm sure they're not feeling too warm and fuzzy right now out there. Carlos on the low cam and Curtis on the right on the high cam as Clay picks up that pass.
That's one of the better offerings right there. It's Clay. It's found.
It is enough yardage for a Flyer first down. Stop was made by number two, R.J.
And they at least moved the chain, so a first down for Lake. See if they can finish off a drive, man, and just try to get some kind of footing, positive footing. Put something positive on tape.
Mm-hmm. That's what you want.
Eastwood 49, Elmwood 35.
49-35, Eastwood over Elmwood.
I think that's going to raise a few eyebrows across the NBC. Cade Boos is a talented quarterback for Eastwood.
That kid's been there for like ever, and that's a long time if you take the four off.
Yep. As the handoff around the left side. And Prophet does not turn the corner as he is dropped for... we'll see if it's no gain or a slight loss. No gain, it looks like. So it's going to be second and 10. Well, partner, I appreciate you coming in here tonight. And I'm going to turn the mantle over to you here for the next couple of weeks. As I got to get some work done on my eyeballs. Here's this one being Clay going up the gut.
Clay will be just dropped by that relentless front of the Genoa Comets. They've been relentless all night. I mean, they've schemed them up well here. They put together a good game plan. I really like defensively what the Genoa Comets have been able to do. They've been disruptive. The defensive line has been very disruptive. Football games are won in the trenches, and we saw that on display here tonight.
Yes, that we have. They go up the gut this time as Clay fights into Genoa territory. He's going to be brought down at about the 45-yard line.
And boy, Clay finally gets through and meets the safety. Logan Rousen, the freshman, he runs in there, and he sees what it's like to play football on Friday nights here.
So it'll be first and 10 here for the Flyers as they will scrimmage from the Genoa 45-yard line. 5 and 15 to go here in this ball game. It's now over on the left side. Blazevic fires a dart. And, well, when it rains, it pours, but it's knocked down. I'm sorry, it was picked off.
Braylon Bryan did a good job, man. All he did is he just feathered the offensive player to the inside, to the outside, and just undercut that pass. That ball has to be thrown to the outside. He threw it too short, and Bryant made a great play on it. Nice play.
Now you see why I'm taking time off to get my eyes worked on. So I honestly thought he knocked it down, but oops. So it'll be first and 10 here for the Comets as they'll close out this ball game with the football.
Well, they'll run it from the spread.
Yep.
And right at you.
They try it. So he's able to drive forward for a couple of.
Well, unlike days of old where Genoa just lined up in the wing tee and really came after you, now they attack you from a lot of different vision points. They really give you a lot to digest. They put the defense in turmoil, and that's what they want to do is create that moment of indecision to where they can find a matchup that's favorable for them.
Well, here we go again, and up the through that line as they work hard to pick up several yards. It'll be third and looks like about four. They'll call it third and three. They'll spot the ball at the Genoa 36, clock winding down.
Yeah, because Will's going to be back.
Drive forward. This will be close to a first.
I think it's going to be just a little bit short from my vantage point.
Clement, the ball carrier. Stop me.
Clement has dropped right. Well, they're going to give him the first down.
They're going to give it to him, yeah.
And nose is just touching the 40-yard line. So that should be enough to play the string out here.
Tight bunch formation. They'll probably run out of that tight bunch.
Well, Flyers blitz, and, well, it's going to be no gain for Luke Clement.
No, it's less field to defend when you're on those tight bunches. Those running plays have got to be real quick hitters.
Yes, they do. So it will be second and 10. So we got 2.5 minutes remaining in this one. Once again, a thank you to all of our sponsors. We really do appreciate you coming on board, being a part of the Toledo Sports Network family.
Actually, the whole freshman class goes down to 10.
As they will go forward again. And this time,
Brock
Matthews is dropped.
Cole Weiss was there.
So that will make it third down. As clock winding down here. Don't forget, by all means, ToledoSportsNetwork.com. Go to the website. You can see all the games that we've done. We really do appreciate you being a part of this here on the Toledo Sports Network. And we've got 90 seconds to go in the game. So, here's the pitch. Clement's driving forward, but he's going to be short of the first down.
Boy, Evan Smith came over there with a bad intent.
Yep, 4th and 4 here for the Comets. Going to wind it down to about 26 seconds before.
Was the cell phone found? If you lost your cell phone.
Well, it looks like they're going to go for it on 4th down. Or it may be a pooch kick. They throw it over here on the left side. And it is complete.
RJ Atkins picks up the first down.
And I think they just wanted that so that they could go into victory formation. So they get into Lake Territory to seal the deal here. Once again, Mr. Gittes is the player of the unsung hero of the game. And Mr. Dar for Lake, brought to you by Taylor Automotive, Family Automotive. And that's going to do it. As the clock winds and hits zero, as Genoa successful in shutting out the Lake Flyers to the tune of 41-0.
Firestone Field at Genoa Bank Stadium.
Well, I tell you, this is one of those games where if you're the Lake staff, you burn the tape, so to speak. If you're Genoa, well, you don't puff yourself up too much. You have to get ready for Otsego next week, so you focus on that.
But you know, there's a lot of things for Genoa to feel good about, but I'm sure when they look back at it, they look at some of the penalties and the missed opportunities that they had. You know, there is teaching moments available. For Lake, it's like, look, they're going to have to find some kind of continuity at the quarterback position. You know, you just can't have three quarterbacks. You're not going to be able to have any kind of offensive continuity, and they lack that from the start tonight.
Well, it's been a great night here for the Genoa Comets as they celebrate opening the official dedication of Jim Firestone Field here inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. So those are all wonderful things that are happening here in the Genoa district, and, well, look forward to seeing what the future brings for the Comets. They've got a lot of good going on right now. So, well, that's going to do it from here at Jim Firestone Field inside of Genoa Bank Stadium. Big thanks once again to Carlos and to Curtis for a job well done on camera. Mike Jameson manning things in the truck. For my partner, Steve Taylor, I'm Mick Gonzalez saying so long, everybody. Your final, once again, the Genoa Comets toss a shutout as they defeat the Lake Flyers 41-0. Been watching high school football. This is the Toledo Sports Network.